Comrades, welcome back to Commander Bitraskiski, and today we are reacting to the Falklands mini wars number one by Oversimplified. Now, comrades, we have reacted to other Oversimplified videos, so comrades, if you want to go check them out, make sure to go check them out, comrades. This is the second episode of Comradathon, so yes, comrade, daily uploads. But anyway, comrades, let's begin.
Hi, English Mariner John Strong. Hi, Anthony Carey, 5th Viscount of Falkland.
So, comrades, obviously, this is the war between the United Kingdom and Argentina, comrades, which happened in the 80s. So, I am pretty interested in this. So I presume this is about them finding the islands.
I found some islands.
My brightness is too high up. What is this capitalist bullshit, comrades? This is what capitalism does to a man, comrade. Makes him blind from the world's problems, comrade. It's true. But I will stop chatting, comrades. Let's try to watch this a little bit. Well, I mean, they are separate islands, comrades, split around the middle, so I'm not surprised.
The Pope drew a line on a map and said all of this belongs to Portugal and all of this belongs to Spain, and that the island was in Spain's territory, and they would like to...
Yes, comrades, but let's be honest, the Pope is bullshit. If you're a Christian, I'm sorry, but that's just what I think. Puerto Soledad, comrade, that is some proper Spanish shit.
...dirty English on the other side of the island take over. So Spain went over to the English and explained, Pope, line on map, Spain's island. And the English said, yeah, right, this is our island. But the Spanish had more guns, so they kicked them off anyway.
Well, comrades, you know, obviously, back in the 1800s, so Spain was a big boy, comrades. Spain was... But, sorry, comrades, but in reality, nowadays, Spain is...
But then King Louis XV said, one, you're insane, and two, you're fired. Sorry, Spain, we're not ready for a war right now. So Spain had to give the English their settlement back, saying it's still our island, and the English said, no, it's our island.
Wow. What a great argument. Disgusting Americans. Come on, do not like America. That's obviously pretty obvious.
But then a French guy, no, not that one.
Word for Pedro. How about no? He looks very bullshit, comrades.
So Spain had a little bit on its hands and also had to leave the islands. And for a couple decades, the islands were left uninhabited except for the penguins...
Come on, Russia could have taken it, but no.
A merchant from Hamburg living in the now independent United Provinces of the Rio de la Plata heard about
the Rio de la Plata, such a long and bullshit name, comrades, not like United Soviet Socialist Republic.
So he got permission from both Buenos Aires and the British government to set up trade there as a private venture. Some American ships came down and began hunting whales and seals around the islands, and Vernet wasn't too happy about it. So
yes, but what are you going to do, comrade? You're pussyhole Argentinians.
But Buenos Aires said, meh, do it yourself. Gave him some weapons and appointed him governor of the islands. So he seized the U.S. ships and arrested their crews. In response, two things happened. First, America came down and said, nice settlement you have there. Would be a shame if someone destroyed it.
Ooh, comrade, this is more
second,
proof of capitalist evil.
Governor, meaning the United
well, has the USSR ever done that? I don't think so. We have never bombed the Falkland Islands, comrades.
So Britain showed up and said, hey, didn't you see our plaque? And since they had more guns, they kicked them off the island. And the Falklands remained firmly in British hands for the next century. They officially became a crown colony in 1840.
Now, comrades, if you ask about my beliefs, I believe they are British. Obviously, comrades, I do not like Britain, but I have to say, obviously, comrades, most of the people are British and shit, comrades, is British. Just like how Crimea is Russian. Keep that in mind, comrades. Ooh, groovy, comrades. I am pretty groovy myself. He just looks like a knock of Hitler.
Struggling for a long time, and Galtieri had been unable to improve the situation. Now, if you ever find yourself the brutal military leader of a struggling South American country, and you start getting into hot water, here's a bit of advice that has been tried and tested throughout the centuries. Start a war to distract everyone from their misery.
Galtieri, fair enough, comrades. That seems like it would work.
Back Argentina's last Malvinas from the occupying British. There had been proposals to cut British military spending, and the ice patrol vessel, HMS Endurance, had been withdrawn from the area. So the Argentinians assumed the British may not even bother doing anything about the invasion. After easily capturing the largely uninhabited South Georgia island, 600 Argentine troops were sent to the Falklands. The small number
only 600, comrades. Wow, that is a pussyhole army, if I've ever seen one.
And had to surrender to the larger Argentine force. Crowds in Argentina celebrated the news, but they were wrong to assume the British would do nothing, because the person in charge of the United Kingdom at the time was this lady.
Oh, comrades, I don't like Margaret Thatcher. Comrades, she is one of the biggest bullshit capitalists I've ever seen.
Iron, for example. She immediately declared an exclusion zone around the islands and organized for a task force of over 100 ships to set sail for...
Well, it's like the last British four, basically. That's Britain, the main character, comrades.
Chile backed Argentina. And since the United States had propped up the Argentine dictatorship, Reagan went to Thatcher and said, could you maybe just let them have the islands? And Thatcher said no.
See, comrades, Americans always dividing their allies, comrades.
Logistical challenge for the British. They requisitioned civilian cruise ships and containers, and they used British-owned Ascension Island as a forward base. By the time they arrived at the Falklands in May, the Argentine forces had had time to entrench themselves. The first task for the British was to gain control of the seas, which they did easily. On the 2nd of May, a British submarine sank an Argentine cruiser. The sinking was controversial, as it occurred outside the British exclusion zone. It was also the largest loss of life.
Comrades, this whole war seems very pointless, comrades. I doubt any the Falklands have anything useful anyway.
The next task for the British was to gain air superiority. While the Argentine Air Force controlled the skies, they were able to inflict considerable damage on the Royal Navy below. Days after the sinking of the General Belgrano, two Argentine superintendars carried out a raid on the HMS Sheffield and sank it with an Exocet missile. For weeks, the Argentine Air Force would continue to carry out raids and inflict heavy casualties on the Royal Navy, with British Sea Harriers doing their best.
Yes, comrades, I see a lot of, obviously, comrades. I'm surprised Britain didn't end this conflict quicker, if I'm serious, comrades. Like, Argentina is not a very strong country, whereas Britain is a massive, you know, comrades, well, not big country. Compared to Russia, it's little pussy all. But it's a bit weird, comrades.
Full-scale raids on the task force ships taking part in the landing, damaging several and sinking a few. But anti-aircraft cannons and Sea Harriers shot down many of the aircraft in what became a major turning point for air superiority.
What the fuck is... I'm so confused how Britain isn't just destroying Argentina.
The north towards Stanley and south
towards Port Stanley, comrades, I used to have a friend called Stanley. He was a very good friend.
The Argentine conscripts put up a good fight, and with the rough, muddy terrain, the war was by no means easy for the British. But with highly skilled Royal Marine commanders and parachute regiment troops, the British would often find themselves taking on larger numbers of Argentinian soldiers, but would still come out victorious with minimal casualties.
Argentina, why are you so shit at everything you do, comrades?
The battle ended in a decisive British victory with over 900 Argentinians.
Comrade, Argentina, you're embarrassing. This is what happens when you have an American dictatorship, comrades. This is what shit happens.
They took control of the hills and mountains surrounding the town as the Argentine forces withdrew, with British ships shelling their positions from offshore. Utterly surrounded, on the 14th of June, the Argentinians surrendered and the war was over. The 2-month-long war
Argentina, wow.
And left the islands strewn with minefields that still pose a problem to this day. Argentina still claims the islands, but in 2013 a referendum...
Argentina, are you stupid? This is like when Ukraine claims Crimea, comrades. It's just quite a lot of bullshit, if I'm serious. Lots of money. Okay, comrades, so that was actually a very good video. Good job, oversimplified. I liked it, comrades, it was very nice, condensed. I still don't understand why Argentina didn't lose quicker, comrades. I don't know why they decided to go to war with Britain, if I'm serious. Britain's one of the world's great powers, and Argentina's a teeny tiny American dictatorship pussyhole, comrades. So, it's a bit bullshit. But anyway, comrades, I hope you enjoyed my reaction, comrades. New video coming tomorrow, every day, comrades, obviously. And please, comrades, make sure to leave a like and make sure to let communism strike again!